Passover between Jesus and his disciples began as a commemoration or celebration of the Passover, and immediately changes into something a little bit different. It became a fraternal meal, a moment for them to talk, a moment for them, for Jesus in particular, to say something special for them. This is the beginning of Jesus' last will for his disciples. Jesus took that particular moment to give himself to the disciples and to us through the sacrament of the Eucharist. And in that particular conversation, he said to the disciples, "Do this in remembrance of me." Words that we heard in today's second reading from Paul to the Corinthians. These words are the same one that we preach, say at every Mass. Do this in remembrance of me. What is the reason for us to do this in remembrance of him? There must be a particular reason for us to do it. And the reason has to do with God's project for all human beings. And God's project is that we become like Jesus. That we transform our lives and become like him. And Jesus explained that in tonight's gospel reading. How we become like him. So the Eucharist is not the end. It's attached to something else. And that something else, tonight, is very important for us to think about it and to meditate about this. And that transformation becomes when we, at the same time, open our hearts to have the same spirit of Jesus. And after that particular meeting, Jesus watched his disciples speak. There's something very interesting in today's gospel reading with a very similar detail that we have to pay attention to. The gospel reading says that Jesus removed his garment and tied a towel around his waist. And after that, he put his garment on. What happened with the towel? The gospel doesn't say that Jesus removed his towel. He put back his garment. And the meaning of this is that Jesus is always serving people. And that is why it's important for the disciples to follow. It's not only to have Jesus in their lives, but it's to show that with their service. That's why the towel has to be at the waist at all times. So the Eucharist and the towel around our waist are going to help us to be like Jesus. La última cena de Jesús con los discípulos comenzó como la conmemoración de la paz y se transformó en una cena fraternal entre Jesús y los discípulos, donde Jesús tiene una conversación con ellos y comienza a darle a ellos los últimos detalles, la herencia que le deja de su último testamento. Y en esa conversación, Jesús le dice a los discípulos y a nosotros, hagan esto en memoria mía. Son las palabras que nosotros los sacerdotes decimos en cada misa que celebramos. Y son las palabras que Pablo utiliza para dirigirse a los Corintios. La razón tiene que ver con el proyecto de Dios para todos los seres humanos. Y ese proyecto no es otra cosa que nosotros nos transformemos, nos convirtamos en alguien con Jesús. Y que hagamos las cosas con el mismo espíritu que Jesús la hizo. Y para dejarnos un ejemplo, Jesús después de la cena dice el Evangelio, se quita la túnica que tenía, se pone una toalla alrededor de la cintura y le lava los pies a los discípulos. Y dice el Evangelio, en un detalle muy particular, que luego de terminar Jesús se puso una vez más la túnica, pero ¿qué pasó con la toalla? El Evangelio no dice que Jesús se quitó la toalla, lo que significa que Jesús se quitó la toalla para seguir sirviendo a los demás. Y ese detalle es sumamente importante para nosotros, para que haya la transformación que Dios quiere que ocurra en nosotros y podamos convertirnos como Jesús es. La Eucaristía no es el fin, la Eucaristía tiene que ir acompañada de la acción. Eso es lo que transforma y nos convierte a alguien como Jesús. Tonight I have some special guests in here in the front. So I'm going to talk to them for a minute. In a few weeks for you, and in more or less a month for others, you are going to be receiving the First Communion. And during that ceremony, there's something that I'm going to be doing that day. And it's the washing of the feet. You know, when the disciples received First Communion, immediately after that, Jesus gave them the task of serving other people. And he did it by showing them how to wash. Tonight we are going to do that to you. And I want you to think about this in particular. Because in your classes you are always doing something to help people. And in this process of the Lenten season, you did something beautiful. And it's that you collected towels and socks that we are going to donate to the homeless of Camilo's house on your behalf. Families, children, like yourself, and other people that are in need of towels to wash themselves and socks to cover their feet are going to be receiving them. So tonight,